Good morning. We were just listening to some
funky music.
To some nice 80s music. Since this Wham song, that's what's happening. But yesterday part of my video got muted because we played music. I didn't know, but Facebook recognizes stuff apparently like this. Bam, and says, you can't use this music unless you have the rights. I guess it's a good thing for the artists, but I didn't think about that. So, just turned off the funky music we were listening to.
But we can have a party with the music in our head. Can somebody guess the tune?
So, hello? Now, do you think the screen's too bright? Now it's good, right?
Now it's good.
Okay, I did it like in the middle. Emma, good morning. So yesterday, I think the whole day we were somehow either on Zoom or on Facebook Live, one of us or both of us, and it made me really think about this whole screen thing and this whole being online, doing stuff together online, which is super great and super nice that it's possible right now. But I also, seeing all those people online, I was like, oh man, I miss being in a room with people. So I just wanted to reiterate that however great this situation right here, this online stuff is as an interim, I think it's super important that when all of this is over, we go back to being together in real life.
Yeah, being really physical.
I'm just gonna move the camera a little bit.
I think it's important to remember that it's important to remember what we're going through now when it's all over, to remember what we're going through now.
Yeah.
And then to meet again, and it's like to see the difference, you know? I wonder how it would be different.
Yeah.
To meet again the studio and doing yoga together. Hopefully the restrictions will be over soon, and we'll be able to do everything that we want to in real life without all these screens.
Yeah.
But I think it's really nice that it opens up possibilities for us that
were
not there before.
I agree. It's great that we can still do stuff. I mean, yesterday I really was like, this is so weird. I'm in my house and I'm so busy. I'm just all day long doing rehearsals, classes, talking to people, meetings.
You did three different online things yesterday.
Yeah. It's quite intense.
Yeah.
I've never had felt that busy before in my own house.
Yeah. And for the past 30 days, you've been teaching every day in online class.
Today is day 30.
Yeah.
Like I keep adjusting the camera. Yes, today is day 30.
I'm going to adjust it.
Yes, please. Welcome everybody to day 30 of the living room yoga every day. Today we talked about doing some twists.
Does it look okay?
It takes 20 seconds for me
mm-hmm.
to see what it looks like.
Okay.
So twisting, very good for the digestive system. Adi and I have started watching a little bit what we eat. We were having a lot of sugary treats and stuff before, and a bit of wine, cheese, all this stuff, and we just decided, okay, let's stop. Let's do a few weeks of being really good. So
dieta.
No more sugar, basically no meat or very little meat, And so we can do some twisting today to kind of detox the belly. Also very good for the spine, obviously. I want to start with a bit of warming up of the hands and feet because I need it. It looks really not crooked, right?
Yeah.
Well, okay, we're just gonna fix the camera angle a little bit. So get yourself situated, get your mat ready. And we'll start in a few minutes.
I think now it's okay. Because I moved this. I made it very, very dark because I put it on the light, but now it looks good there. It's not burned anymore.
Okay.
I think this is kind of straight.
Yeah.
We have all these gadgets now. The phone with an extra lens and an extra microphone.
Well, we keep finding gadgets in my stuff that I just still have.
Yeah. But like I never thought about a phone with an extra lens on it and an extra microphone and a tripod that holds it.
Yeah, the phone is really a wizard.
Mm-hmm. How crazy is it that 2007 was the first iPhone?
Is that so crazy?
Yeah, like look what happened in the last 13 years.
Asher. Ah, okay, let's do the round of hellos and then we really start. Emma, we already had. Hello, Emma. From London. Michal. Good morning, Michal. Boker Tov. From Israel. Manu, like me. Claire. Good morning. I'm assuming Claire is also somewhere in the UK. And Dolores from Brussels. Good morning, Dolores. I dreamt about you last night. And Asher also Brussels. Good morning, Asher. Good morning, guys, says Asher.
And
2007
so
with the first iPhone, that's crazy. And so is Corona. Yes, Corona is crazy. Okay.
Okay, let's do it.
Let's do it. I take one more sip of tea. Come to a seated position on your mat. You can sit on a block or pillow. Any way that's comfortable for you. Place your hands somewhere on your knees or thighs. Close your eyes. Take a few deep breaths. Arriving here in your body, in this room, on this morning, any tension in your pelvis, pelvic floor, perineum, let your tail uncurl, and let the contents of your pelvis rest down, sink down. Release your front of your thighs, hip flexors. flexor muscles. Keeping your eyes closed, you can gently place your hands on top of those muscles, on top of your hips. Lean a little bit forward and just give very gentle pressure down. Down into the front of your hips, front of your thighs. Just gently pressing a little bit of weight down into your tops of your legs. Encouraging your lower body to sink down more into the floor. Walking your hands slowly down your thighs, back towards your knees. Come to rest. Start lengthening your in-breaths and your out-breaths. And as you're breathing in, feel your ribs gently lifting up and away from your hips. Pelvis sinking down heavy into the floor. While your rib cage floats up and away. Opposition forces your sit bones pulling down into the floor, down into the ground. Top of your head floating up. Releasing the back of your neck up, chin slightly, slightly down, your jaw soft, shoulder blades sliding down the back. Rib cage floating up and away. Keeping your eyes closed, press your left back of your hand against the inside of your left knee and open your right hand up to the right. Super gentle twist. Twist starting from the tail, moving up the whole spine. Take it very gentle and soft. Breathing in and out here a few times deeply. Floating the ribcage up as you breathe in. Twisting a little bit more as you breathe out. Gently change sides. Back of your right hand on the inside of your right knee. Left hand moving a little bit diagonally behind you. You can use the left fingertips, gently starting to twist. Still releasing hips and knees down to the floor. A few times deeply breathing in, lifting the ribcage away from your hips. Breathing out, twisting a little bit more. Back to the center. You can open your eyes, take your right foot. Just give a little bit of pressure into that foot. You can put it either on your leg or keep it on the floor. Use your thumbs. Wake up the soles of your feet. Giving a bit of a rub. pressure down into the ankle using the weight of your torso. As little effort as possible here, just waking up your foot, putting the foot down on the floor, rubbing the top of your foot with, you can use your knuckles or the palms of your hands. Whole top of the foot and the ankle, waking it up gently. And then grab your big toe, pull it towards your heel, and your second toe, pull it towards the top of your foot, so it'll split between those two toes, stretching the skin between the toes. Change direction, big toe coming towards the top of the foot, second toe pointing down towards the heel. You can give it a gentle wiggle. Moving all the way down the foot this way. So pulling the second toe towards the top of the foot, third toe down towards the heel. Stretching the skin between those two toes. Gently wiggling. Changing the direction between those two toes. And this way, moving down the whole foot. Gently splitting between the toes in both directions. And when you reach the end, take your foot and just pull all the toes towards the heel a few times, like a passive pointing of the foot, and put your heel down in front of you, pull the ball of the feet, all the toes towards you. Gentle waking up of the foot. Then switch feet. Take your left foot. Start by just rubbing the sole of your feet with your thumbs or with your hand palms. Pressing a little bit of weight into that foot. Waking up the skin on the soles of our feet that carry us day in, day out. A lot of work they do. Step your foot down and rub top of it with knuckles or hand palms, rubbing out both sides of the ankles, tops of the toes. Start your toe splitting exercise. Start by pulling your big toe towards the heel, second toe towards the top of the foot. And really stretching the skin between the toes, switching directions. You can use gentle jiggling with your hands to increase this stretch. Move all the way down the foot that way, splitting between your second and third toe now, gently wiggling. Five toes towards the heel a few times, maybe your toes crack, stretching the arch of the foot. your heel down, grab the top of your foot with your hand and pull your toes towards the ankle. You can pull your foot a little bit side to side, stretching the Achilles, stretching the tops of the toes. Bring your foot back to sitting. Take a moment with your eyes closed, noticing any sensations in your feet. In front of you, rub them against each other for a moment, creating a bit of heat. Then rub the backs of your hands one by one. Place your backs of your hands on the floor with your fingers pointing towards you. Hands on the floor, wrists pointing forwards, palms facing up, gently leaning the weight into the tops of the wrists, stretching out tops of wrists. If you want to increase this, bend your elbows a little bit in towards your torso. And then flip the hands, place the palms of your hands on top of the floor and lift your wrists up. You can lean your weight a little bit forward, increasing the stretch. Take your hands off. Take your right thumb and stretch it to the side, so towards the inside of your elbow. You can use your left fingers on the outside of the wrist and the left thumb to pull the right thumb closer in. Big stretch. And stretch your right index finger away from the palm, top of the finger coming towards the front of the wrist. Move down your whole hand this way, finger by finger. Big stretch on the base of each finger. Once you've done all five fingers, take your right thumb and pull it in towards the palm, the tip of the thumb coming towards the base of the pinky finger. And then to increase the stretch, you can straighten through the elbow. Thumbs always need a little bit more attention than the rest of the fingers because they have so many more ways to move. They have so many directions in which they can be moved, so they can also be stretched in more directions. Moving down to the index finger, same thing, pull it in towards the inside of the wrist. And then you can experiment with the position of the wrist here, see what gives you the biggest stretch. For me, if I pull my wrist in all the way, I get get a stretch on top of the wrist and on top of the finger. But for some people, stretching through the elbow can work better. Or if it's too intense, you can also keep your wrist straight and only stretch the finger here. Moving all the way down through each finger. So that we can work from the outside in, which is something especially as dancers we're not so used to. We work often from the inside out with a lot of focus on core, and the limbs follow the core, but it can be really interesting sometimes to flip that. Something that Adi works with a lot, actually. There's a different perspective, different way of moving. So we moved on to the left hand, pulling the left thumb towards the inside of the palm, tip of the left thumb, tip of the left thumb pulling towards the inside of the pinky finger, the base of the pinky finger. And moving down the whole hand like this, holding your fingers in towards the inside of your wrist, experimenting with the position of the wrist. Maybe you want to straighten through the arm, maybe you want to bend the arm and pull the finger more down one by one. Last thumb stretch. Pull the thumb towards the inside of your forearm now. Keep breathing. Change sides. Left thumb towards the inside of the forearm. Take all the fingers, stretch your hands straight in front of you, take all your fingers towards your face, and really strongly straighten through your right elbow. Then flip the palm, pull your fingers all towards your chest. Again, straightening through your elbow. Let it go, change sides. All your five fingers. Palm right in front of the shoulder, wrist in front of the shoulder. Pulling your fingertips towards your face. Straighten through the left elbow strongly. And then pull the fingers in the opposite direction towards your chest. Palms are down on the floor and your wrist face forward. Lean them onto the floor. Push down into the palms. Maybe starting to pull your elbows into the chest. stretching the root of your wrist here. Keep the rest of the body relaxed, top of your neck, shoulders, hips. Gently, gently peeling the palms off the floor. Sitting on your knees, tucking the toes under, use your hands to make sure all of your toes are facing forward and not starting to turn to the side. Trying to get the full bottom of each toe to be on the floor, so we're not grabbing the toes like this. Trying to see if you can have the full surface of the inside or the bottom of each toe touching with the floor, putting your weight on your heels, maybe walking your hands slightly behind your hips, opening the feet. See if you can feel as much surface of the bottom of your toes as possible. You can wiggle your ankles a little bit out and in, stretching the bottom of your toes. And then stop in the middle with the ankles. Push your pelvis, tuck your pelvis in. Push a little bit up, just a gentle waking up of the front of the hips. Let that go. Walk your hands forward and come to all fours. Spreading out the fingers as wide as you can. You can keep your toes tucked to feel this surface of the toes, the surface of the bases of the toes on the floor, cat-cowing a few times in your own breath, breathing in, hollowing out the back, keeping the full surface of the hands and feet on the floor. Breathing out, rounding. Four more times, this in your own time. Back to a neutral spine. Push down into your hands to lift your knees just slightly off the floor, activating the core. And take a few gentle circles. Circles of the wrists, circles of the hips, circles of the knees. And reverse the direction. Grounding through your hands, pushing through the bases of your toes. Stop in the middle, place your knees back down. You can untuck your toes, lift your right hand up. Gentle twist. Then stick that hand underneath the left. Pushing down through the left hand to twist your back very gently. Roll your right cheek to the floor. Crawl your left fingertips forward and then towards the right, over your head. Press down into that left palm. Straighten out your hips. Maybe looking up underneath your left armpit. To come out, roll your right cheek back down. Crawl your left fingertips back. Push into the left hand to come back into all fours. Breathing out, rounding the back. Breathing in, arching the back. Come back to neutral. Lift the left hand up. Stick it down underneath the right. Press into your right hand. Twist your back. Take it very easy, gently here. And roll your left cheek down to the floor. Crawl your right fingertips forward. And then take them overhead towards the left. Even at your hips. Pressing down through the right hand palm. Maybe looking up underneath your right armpit. Gently roll your face back down. Crawl your right fingers back. Push down into your right hand. Come back into all fours, straight away rounding your back down. Softening the chest. Arching your back. Tuck your toes under. From this arch back, push into a downward facing dog, spreading your fingers wide. Walk your feet. Push your hips up, sit bones up to the ceiling, heels down into the ground. Take this downward dog a little bit smaller than your normal downward dog, so a little bit of a smaller distance between hands and feet. Then firmly press down into the left hand, lift the right hand and grab the left outside of the ankle, gently twisting your back. Keep your hips evenly reaching up, sit bones reaching up, heels pressing down, looking up underneath your left elbow, ankle, armpit, sorry. Gently release, place your right hand, really spread the fingers as wide as possible and put the weight into that hand and lift the left, reaching the right outside of the ankle with the left hand. Use that hand to pull yourself into a gentle twist. Keep your heels pressing down, sit bones pulling up, looking down underneath your right armpit. gently coming out of this. Pressing now evenly through both hands, fingers spread. Drop your head, lift your sit bones up. The soft part of the elbows is facing up to the ceiling. Then look up at your hands. Take very small steps to come to the top of your mat. Notice the moment that the weight shifts from your hands to your feet. Hang down here for a moment. You can bend your knees a little bit. Stick your sit bones again up and out. With the knees bent once, come halfway up. Sticking your ribs, the base ribs, out, and then put your whole belly on top of your thighs, rounding down. Keep the legs bent as much as you need to keep this connection between the belly and the thighs. And then super gently work towards straightening your legs. They don't straighten all the way. Doesn't matter, but try to keep the connection between the belly and the thighs. You can have the hands next to the feet and press a little bit down into your knuckles to help keep this connection. Keep the top of your neck long. Crown of the head pulling down into the floor. Sit bones pulling up to the ceiling. And gently let it go, bend through your knees, start to roll up your spine. Open your palms, stand upright. Shift the weight onto your left leg, lift the right knee. Then position the right foot on top of your left thigh with the knee facing forward. So your right leg is parallel. Put your right hand on the inside of that right knee, left hand on your hip. And then press against the inside of your knee to twist yourself gently. To the left. Let it go and switch sides. So now put the outside of your left hand on the outside of the right knee. Place your right hand on your right hip. Push against that knee with the outside of your left hand to twist towards the right. Gently coming back to the middle. Step your right foot down. Shift the weight onto the right foot, lifting the left foot, putting it on top of your right thigh, placing the left back of the hand on the inside of the left knee, twisting towards the right. your arms up, breathing in. And swan diving down. Coming halfway up. Same feeling as before with the sit bones pointing up. Stepping into plank. 5 breaths to explore your plank a little bit. Spreading out the fingers. So your middle fingers are pointing straight forward. And the other 4 fingers are spreading as wide as they can. Heels pulling towards the back wall. Belly button is in towards the spine. Place your knees down on the floor with control. Now bring your chin and your chest down so your hips stay up. Just for a moment, wiggle out your hips side to side. And pushing through the foot, feet, and hands, sliding your chest through. Come into a small cobra, untuck your toes. Shoulder blades are moving close together behind your spine. Chest is coming forward. And if it's comfortable for your neck, you can lift your chin up and away from your chest. Take one more in breath and come a little bit higher up. And gently roll down. Tuck your toes. Stick your hips up again. Now start to walk your hips a little bit closer. One by one. Throat staying down on the floor. If this is intense enough, stay here. If you want to go on, straighten through the right leg. Keeping the toes first on the floor. Again, you can stay here if it's enough. If you want to move on, point through that right foot and lift the leg up. And gently coming back down, flexing the foot. Place the knee back down, changing legs. First, straightening the left knee. Are still up. You can stay here if it's enough, or lift the leg, pointing through the foot. Gently coming back down, flex through the foot to put it down onto the floor, bending the knee, then push through the hands to come back into all fours. Come into downward dog. Hands. And point through the foot and pull your right knee in towards the left armpit, twisting. Maybe the knee comes all the way to the outside of the left elbow. Hover there for a moment and bring it back. Back to parallel. And this time, bring the knee to the outside of the right elbow. Hovering for a moment. bring it back. Still parallel. And this time bring the knee to the middle. Hover for a moment before you step the foot down between the hands. Lift your chest up. Come onto your fingertips. And then bring your left knee down. Lift your hands up to prayer in front of your chest. And twist towards the right. Place your left elbow on the outside of your right knee. Press down into your right hand to twist your back. Now straighten through your left knee, twisting more. Bring your hands back to the middle and float them up into Warrior One. Bring your left knee back down. Reach your right arm behind you. Reach to the back of your left leg. Gentle twist of the spine. You can stay here. Reaching your right hand up. Twisting the back more. And then if you're ready for it, you can bend back. So your right shoulder is coming towards your left hip, twisting and back bending at the same time. Gently let go. Reach your right arm back and up. Lean your whole torso forward, bring your hands down, straighten through the left knee, step the right foot back, try to round it down with straight legs or your knees on the floor, coming to upward dog, into downward facing dog, with an optional extra push-up. Three deep breaths here. Lift your left foot up. Come to parallel. Foot flexed. Hips both facing forward. Pressing down through the hands equally. Point through the left foot. Bring the knee in towards the right armpit, in towards the outside of the right knee, ankle, elbow. Fuck. Hover there for a moment. Coming back to parallel. This time bringing your knee to the outside of the left elbow. Elbow, it's called. Hover for a moment. Bringing it back. Still parallel position with the leg. Then bringing the knee into the chest. Hover for a moment before you step your left foot down between your hands. Come onto your fingertips, reaching your chest forward, then drop drop your right knee down. Lift your hands, bring them into prayer in front of the chest. Then lift your ribcage up to twist over to the right side. Right elbow on the outside of your left knee. Pushing down into your left hand, twisting, twisting, twisting. Lift your right knee up. Gently untwist. Lift your arms up into Warrior One. Your left arm back and behind you, reaching for the outside of your right thigh, twisting your right shoulder towards the your left shoulder towards the right hip. Reach your right shoulder up. You can stay here if it's enough, or start to bend back, bending back and twisting at the same time. Coming out of this, reach your left arm back and up, and reach both arms forward on the diagonal. Come down with your hands next to your foot, straighten for the right leg, step into plank, chaturanga down, upward facing dog. Into downward facing dog with an optional extra push-up. Come down to child's pose. Stay there for 10 breaths. Your toes, come back into downward dog. Reach your sit bones up to the ceiling, the heels away and down from the sit bones. Look up at your hands. You can step or jump back. Coming halfway up, rolling back down. Bend through the knees, roll up your spine, palms facing forward. Shift the weight into the left foot. Same exact thing we did before, reaching the right foot up and placing it on top of your left thigh. Slip your right hand on the inside of your right forward with a straight back. Reach the left arm behind your back and see if you can bind around the knee. Right arm inside of the knee, left arm around your back. From here, twisting, open towards the left with a straight back. Coming back with your back to the middle, balancing, rolling your back up and lifting the leg up with you. Coming to standing straight for a moment. Going back the same way, placing your foot back on your thigh. Release the bind. Stand back up with your palms facing forward. Now lift your right foot up. Float your hands up. Start to bend through the left knee. Reach your right foot back and step into a warrior one. Reach your right hand over the top of your left knee, twisting. Bring it all the way down to the floor. Coming onto fingertips or onto a block if you'd like. Reaching the left hand up. Balancing here. Using the inside of your right arm, almost armpit, to push yourself more up and away from the leg. Reach the left arm overhead and circle it down. Step it in front of your right. Step your right hand on the inside of your foot. Now lift your right hand forward and up. Sinking your hips down. From here, drop your right heel down to the floor. Come up into warrior two. Down, reaching the right arm up and the left hand coming into your lower back. Reaching your ribs up and away and then a slight back bend with a twist. Keeping your right knee straight. Gently coming back up. Reach your left arm up. Opening your whole torso to the side and opening back into warrior two. Windmilling your arms down. Hands on either side of your foot. Lift the right heel up. Step into plank. Chaturanga down, upward facing dog, downward facing dog. Look up at your hands, step or jump back, come halfway up, weight into the right foot, lift your left knee up, step the left foot onto your right thigh parallel, balancing here. Now slip your left hand inside your left knee, right hand reaching back, come down with a straight long back, and then see if you can bind, folding the right hand behind your back, and the left arm wraps around your leg, around your left leg, shin bone, and twisting open towards the right. Bring your back down into the middle, then with a long back start to stand up, bringing your leg along with you, standing upright with your left leg up, reaching your chest up and out, coming back down the same way you came in, reaching the left foot for the left thigh, for the right thigh, unclasp the hands, come back up with a straight back, hand palms facing forward, lift your left leg, keep it lifted, reach your arms up, start to step your left foot back. See if you can step into Warrior One with no adjustments. Now twist your back to the right side, your left hand reaching forward, coming to the outside of your right foot. Reaching your right hand up, sinking your hips down, using your left inner arm to push yourself more, twist your back more up. Circle your right hand up and over, step it down, step your left hand over the foot. Now leaning on the right hand, reach your left arm forward and up. Rib cage is reaching up and away from the hips. Hips are sinking down. Then drop your left heel down to the floor, slowly look down at your right hand and lift both arms up, coming into Warrior Two. Outside of the left foot, pressing down into the floor, right thigh parallel to the floor. Straighten through the right knee, drop both arms down and reach your left arm forward and up. Right hand comes into your lower back. Reach your whole ribcage up and over to bend gently back. Twisting and back bending at the same time. Gently come back, reach your right hand up, twist your torso open to the side, Bend through the right knee, come back into your warrior two. Then wind bring both your arms down, lift your left heel, step the right foot back into plank, chaturanga down, upward dog. Into downward facing dog. Pulling your sit bones up and away from the heels. Relaxing your head and your neck. Then look up at your hands, step or jump back, reaching halfway up, rounding down, bend through your knees to roll all the way up, open your palms, slide your shoulders down the back. Reach your arms up, breathing in, and bring your hands down, palms together, prayer in front of your chest. Close your feet together, heels and ankles touch. Reach your ribcage up, sit down into a chair. Your hips coming far behind you. You look down at your feet, your knees aren't over your feet, you can still see the whole foot. Knees are above your ankles, back is arching, chest leaning forward, breathing in, lifting the ribs up and away from the hips and twisting over to the right. Make sure your knees stay even, pressing down into the right hand. Sit down lower, arch your back, lift your chest forward and up. Gently untwist, come back to the middle. Breathing in, lifting your ribcage up and away, changing sides, right elbow on the outside of your left knee. Make sure your knees are even. Pressing down into your left hand, twisting open more. Reach your hips further back, ribs further forward and up. Look down, untwist, reach your arms up, sit back, a little bit lower down, then reach your hands forward straight through your legs. Halfway up, step or jump back into plank, chaturanga down, upward facing dog, into downward facing dog. Now this is going to be mostly for fun. Attempting to balance here. on one hand, one leg, one foot and one hand. Reach your right foot up. Press strongly down into the right hand. Reach your left hand up. Bend the right knee. See if you can reach the inside of the right ankle. It's just an attempt. Balancing. Once you grab hold of the right ankle, then you start to push the foot into the hand. Balancing, balancing, twisting. Try one more time. And let it go. Change sides. Lifting the left foot up. Bend the knee, press firmly down into the left hand, spreading those fingertips. Reach the right hand up. See if you can grab the inside of the left ankle. And if you manage, then push that foot into your hand. Trying a little bit longer. And if you keep falling, it doesn't matter. Gently come out of it. Come into a child's pose for a moment. Active child's pose. Keep your toes tucked under. Walk your hands forward. And a little bit closer together, so your elbows are close together. Drop your head. Breathe into your armpits. Push yourself up into downward dog. Reach your right foot up. Point through the foot, lift the hip. Your right armpit is reaching down and away from your right hip. Drop that right foot, open up the knee to the ceiling, and slowly start to reach the foot down to the floor, moving the weight into the left hand. You can lean on the right ball of the foot, open up the chest. Your torso up, and we're gonna reach the right hand on the inside of the right knee, pushing with the elbow against the knee, reaching the left hand around your back, grabbing the top of the thigh, twisting open. This is option one. reach your right elbow underneath your right knee, reach behind your back, binding. Once you're bound, drop your hips and lift your torso up. And then the next step is to straighten through your left knee, balancing, twisting open more and more and more. Come out of it, look down, untwist. Place your knee back down. Reaching the torso up. Now exactly the opposite, so reaching the left elbow on the outside of the right knee. You can bring your right hand to your lower back, twisting the back open, sinking your hips forward and down. That's option one. You can stay here, or next step is to try and bind, reaching your torso down, folding the left hand behind . This is a tricky one. It helps to put the left thumb on the lower part of your thigh and then twist the hand to reach your right hand, binding. Once you're in the bind, open your right shoulder up to the ceiling, and then straightening through the left knee, twist, twist, twist. To come out of it, look down, put your left knee down, untwist. Coming to a lunge. Let's do a lizard here. Both hands on the inside of your right foot. Walk the right foot a little bit out towards the edge of your mat. Reaching your elbows down. You can keep your left toes tucked to encourage your left hip to stay forward, or you can untuck the toes. Belly hang. Maybe let your knee fall open, peeling the sole of your foot gently off the floor of the right foot. Gently come out of this, place your foot back down, reach into your wrists, leaning into the wrist to take the weight back, step the right foot a bit back and in, straighten the left knee, step into plank, chaturanga down. Upward facing dog, you can hang out here for a moment, stretching out those hips. Come back into a downward dog. Pressing your heels down towards the floor, reaching your sit bones up and away. Pressing down into all of your fingers, your hands are spread out. Lift your left foot up. Start pointing the foot, open the hip, reach your foot more up. Equal weight between the hands. And drop your left foot, reach your knee more up to the ceiling, still reaching your left armpit down away from the knee. Then start to drop the left foot down to the floor. Shift weight into the right hand. Reaching down with the left ball of the foot, open your chest. Retrace your steps. Come back into your down dog splits. Then reach your left knee into the chest. Rolling forward, step the foot down. Drop your right knee down. Bring your torso up. Reach your left elbow on the inside of your left knee. Reach your right hand behind your back and grab hold of the inner left thigh, using that left elbow to push yourself further into a twist. This is step one. If you want to go deeper, start to bind. So reach your torso a little bit down. Unwrap the right hand. Reach the left hand down underneath your left leg. Your elbow is coming on the inside of your knee, grabbing your hands behind your back. Then shifting your hips down. Opening the right shoulder to the ceiling and then straightening through the right knee, twisting more. To come out, gently look down, unbind the hands, drop the knee back down. Reaching the torso up, twisting in the opposite direction, sliding your right hand now down, right elbow reaching outside of the left knee. You can place your left hand on your lower back to give a bit of pressure to twist more. And if from here you want to move on, a little bit down with your torso, reach the right hand below the left thigh. And you can use this thumb here for leverage, twisting the hand, then grabbing your left hand from behind, pushing on the outside of the knee with the right ankle, twisting your left shoulder up to the ceiling, then lengthening your right leg, balance here, reach your ribs away from the hips and twist, twist, twist. Gently come out, looking down at the floor, dropping your right knee, unbinding the hands. Place both hands inside your left foot. Step the left foot a little bit out. Coming into lizard. Slowly taking your time. Start to bring your elbows down onto the floor, or you can use a block here. And dropping the head down, letting the belly flop out. Maybe start to peel the sole of the right of the left foot off the floor, letting the knee fall open. child's pose actually. Open your knees a little bit. And drop your torso down between the legs, between the knees. Lengthen your back. Walk your hands a little bit forward and close together. Walk your elbows close together. And drop your head, bend the elbows. Bring hands into prayer behind your head. Gently uncurl your arms, rolling your spine up, come to sitting with your left leg long, your right leg long, left foot in front of your pelvis, hips are a bit open. Start upright, reach your left arm up, breathing in, lifting the whole ribcage up, folding down over the right side. Starting really gently, deep side bend. Gently coming down, down, down. And if you can, grab the top of the right foot with the left hand. Move your right elbow inside the right knee. You can use that elbow for leverage to start twisting your back up and open. Left armpit reaching up, right hand walking more forward. Pulling from your right hand palms. Twisting open your spine towards the ceiling. Deep breathing, twist, twist, twist. Gently uncurling. Coming out of this. Take your right foot. Place it over the top of your left knee. Walk your left foot a little bit more out to the side so that both your sit bones can reach the floor. Reach behind your sacrum with your right hand. You can use that hand to sit yourself up straight. Reach the left arm up and twist it over. Elbow on the outside of your right knee, pressing into the elbow to twist yourself. Breathing in, lifting the ribcage up. Breathing out, twist yourself more. Now if you want, you can bind here, reaching the left hand down into the crook of your knee, the right hand coming behind your back, grabbing your hands, using the twisting. Back upright. Turning and twisting. 5, 4, 3, a little bit more, 2, 1. Gently let it go. Do a little counter twist. And then straighten out your left leg. Right foot in front of your pelvis. Reach your right hand up. Breathing in, lifting the whole rib cage up to bend over. Letting the weight of the head and torso pull you down gently. And if this is enough, stay here. If you want more, reach the top of your left foot with the right hand. Sneak your left hand through, coming in front of your knee. First, use the elbow, the left elbow against the left knee to pull your back open to the ceiling. And then you can walk your left hand more forward, crawling the fingertips, encouraging your right armpit to open up to the ceiling, twist. And gently let it go. Rolling back up. Grab your left foot. Step it on the outside of your right knee. Walk your right foot a little bit more to the left so there's space for your sit bones to come both down. Reach your left hand behind your sacrum, pushing down into the floor to lengthen through your back. Right arm comes up, reaching up and twisting the elbow, comes on the outside of the right knee. Use that elbow as leverage, pressing yourself into a twist. On the in-breath, you're reaching your ribcage up, out-breath, twisting more. And then if you want to bind, bend that right elbow, sneak the right hand through the hole there. Reach your left arm behind your back. Bind your hands, pushing into the outside of the left knee with the right elbow. Same thing, breathing in, lifting your ribcage more up, lengthening the back. Breathing out, twisting more. Twist, twist, twist. And gently untwist. Take an easy counter twist. Back to the middle. Lie down on your back. Take your knees into your chest for a moment. Lengthen your left leg down. Keep pulling your right knee into the chest, towards your right shoulder. and start to pull that knee now, twisting it in towards the left shoulder, very slowly pulling it until the right hip starts to peel off the floor. Very slowly, enjoying every step on the way, gently bringing that right knee down to the floor, aiming to keep the right shoulder on the floor, reaching your right arm long to the right side, rolling your head to the right. You can use the left hand on top of the right knee to gently ease it down to the floor, twisting your whole back. Gently come back out of this. Use the left hand to peel the right knee off the floor. Come back the same way you came in, pulling the knee into the chest. Very slowly, for a moment, stay here with the knee twisting towards the left shoulder, right hip rolling down. And take the knee out towards the right shoulder, all the way until the foot hits the floor, the right foot. Release the grip on the knee and let the leg slide down. Your left knee in towards the chest. Start by pulling it in towards the left shoulder, using the weight of your hands, minimum effort, letting the weight of the hands pull the knee a little bit closer. Right hand, very slowly start to pull the knee across the chest towards the right shoulder, twisting as close as you can with the knee to the torso, enjoying every little step on the way, gently letting your left hip start to roll off the floor. Bring the knee down, down slowly. Open your left hand to the side. Encouraging your left shoulder to stay on the floor. Turn your head towards the left. You can use the right hand on top of the knee. Soften the knee down. Deep breathing. The whole back twisting. Let your tailbone uncurl, soften. Top of the neck relaxed. minimum effort lifting your left knee the same way you came into this. Lifting it up close towards your right shoulder first, twisting. And letting the hips sink down. Then switching hands and letting the knee come down towards the outside of the left shoulder. Leaning with your left elbow into the floor. All the way until the foot reaches the floor. Let go of the knee, let go of the hip. Slide the leg down. Come to Shavasana pose. You can have your feet a bit wider apart than hip width. Hand palms facing the ceiling. Let your whole body drop, your whole body drop down into the floor. Spine today, twisting and curving, back bending and forward folding. Stimulating the discs between the spine, the vertebrae, the discs between each vertebrae. They're full of water, they're really squishy and cushiony. By twisting, we encourage them to squeeze out and renew their liquids. Keeping the whole spine mobile, squishy and soft. Let's start from the top of the head and intuitively scan very slowly through your whole spine. See if there's anything more you can release. Anywhere along this very intricate pathway of the spine that houses the central nervous system. Top of your head, base of the skull, the vertebrae of the neck, into the thoracic spine, the vertebrae that connect to each rib. Through all of your vertebrae in each direction. We tend to think of the spine as something that's in the back, but actually the spine, the front of the spine is in the center of our bodies. So think also of the front of your vertebrae. moving down to the middle of your back. The organs of your belly resting on the front of your spine. Spine connecting to the pelvis. All the way down to the floating coccyx that used to be the tail. The remnants of our tails uncurling. Softening. The whole spine breathing, soft and mobile. Stay there as long as you want. If you're ready to come out, once you're ready to come out, start to gently wiggle toes and fingers, rolling your head side to side, rolling yourself to one side, resting there for a moment. So much for joining. It's been 30 days, every day 8:30, and we're gonna be here every day as long as it lasts, this weird situation. Enjoy the rest of your day. Have some nice food. Enjoy the sunshine if you have it, and I hope to see you again tomorrow morning.